there you can see the confidence of the protecting you see the renewed confidence, and you have the batting section building up that entourage that you seem to be having. But, you know, from an in-ring standpoint, how do you feel like you've grown as a performer? Kind of give us an inside look at just the work that you're doing.
I work in a company of people who have worked indies, who've done something for 10 plus years. I'm entering my second year. I'm working with one of the best technical wrestlers in wrestling in general. I feel like my progression is amazing. Brian did an interview where he said that he didn't feel comfortable until 6 years. It's my second year. I feel like I'm killing shit.
How has your life changed, you know, being a pro wrestler, and how have you adapted to this new kind of life?
So I was a previous athlete. It's not that hard, but wrestling is a whole different world in general. Just from the fans, the schedules, the long hours, the commitment. It's different, and I'm still learning.
You got some new representation today. I think someone was reading my last talk article that I put out. And, not pointing any fingers. Stokely Hathaway debuted tonight to represent a card that I think is the best pairing in the history of wrestling, possibly. How do you feel having a new representation in Stokely?
He's the best talking man. Who would want anything less than that? Somebody to represent a superstar that's about to just come forth in front of all your best friends. I think Tony Khan made the best decision that he could ever make in this situation.
If I may, I was in a very unique position too. So it was pretty unusual. Stokely's 90 days expired yesterday. So I have never met him or spoken to him until today. So it just so happened that the 90 days expired, I had this idea. And we were lucky. I mean, there's a lot of independent wrestling and stuff going on. I think he's been around. I guess he's been around Vegas. I had never met him until today, I swear on my life. I never had a conversation with him. I've had him in mind since 2018, actually. Since, like, early. I mean, I remember being way back in the day, actually, with Cody. And I was saying I really liked Stokely Hathaway. And Stokely Hathaway, I'm a big fan of him. And it's funny because he came in today with Stokely Hathaway. Having had another name recently with another promotion. I never had this conversation with him, so today I told him I want you to be Stokely Hathaway. I'm the owner of Ring of Honor. You have a great history of Ring of Honor, and not only did I explain I wanted to pair him with the world's greatest network champion, the world's top undefeated pro wrestler 2 years in with such a sparkling record, and add to the presentation that's already come so far so fast. And like Jade said, he's a great talker, and I literally never met him or spoken to him. We had never talked or spoken until today, which is pretty cool that it worked out. Yeah, it was great.
Seriously,
time.
Guys, I didn't know anything until I didn't know anything. This like was a surprise to me just as much as everybody else in this room. Trust me, I was excited just as much as you were.
It made for a great moment. I think it was a great surprise for the fans, and the timing sometimes, like, we were fortunate sometimes, and that was great timing. And he expired. That's cool. I think it's an obvious solution, right? Putting one of the great champions in wrestling with one who's already got so much charisma with a great talker, and they can be like Bockwinkel and Heenan, you know, a great talker with another great talker and a great mind. So I think they can be the new Bockwinkel and Heenan.
Jay, congratulations, right? What does that title mean to you? Because on one hand, it's about proving yourself, and another hand, it's about representation and diversity. And as you carry it, is the significance of the change in the title of the title?
So, when I first got the belt, I was like, damn, this is a lot. I feel like it was a weight.